world, it's ay-musik. Hello world, it's ay-musik. And you can roll with it or refuse it. I say hey, way to the world. This is my day. Something like BK, have it my way. This is my time, I'ma shine, I'ma shine so high.
Hey.
Yo, he be the one them call Timo Peach.
And he is clearly ay-young. And this is the Global Goals Music Roadshow.
Yeah, guys. And this is a show that's designed to empower you, to change your world with us, you know, to achieve the big goal of a healthier future for the planet. See, our mission is to turn the people of the world, humans, you, into the battery that powers change using, charged with the universal language of music.
Yeah, baby. I'm in the UK. He's in the US. With both musicians and creatives passionate about transforming the world and helping ordinary people feel that they, you, can take part. You're allowed. Now, we found our passion, our voices, our confidence through practicing music and art. And this is some of his music.
To finish, the world needs good people. Together we can make it if we try. Black skin, white skin was made to be equal. No matter what the age, the fame, we all just human. I can feel you listen. You notice what I say. Hey, you can catch me fighting. I'm ready for a change. So I said, I'm ready for a change. Gonna change my ways for a brighter day, brighter day. Come on, yeah. I said, I'm ready for a change.
And this is some of his music.
Nostalgia like crack addict into looking back on where all our ways goes. We guess somebody knows now. Nothing's as it used to be. Cause it's not about you or me. Any joy, any grief, I can feel the relief to let go, to know I am free.
And now we want to encourage you to find your passion, your voice, your confidence, and feel part of writing, singing, and living some new stories of us, because it's time.
Boom, yeah. Yes, it's time, Timo. Like, we believe that everyone in the world is an outlet for change. That means you, me, Burger King, big corporations, all of us, right? Like, it doesn't matter how big we are or how small we think we are. No, we're on a mission to get you, everyone, to outlets, right? To get outlets plugged in, to power this battery for change. I always say that the battery tour is an outlet for you to plug in and connect to your passion. So no matter who you are, we hope to inspire you to do two things. Power the tour, take an action. Because you can.
Passion, we think, is where it all starts. This is, we like to call it, the people show for changing the world. I quite like that. That's not a bad tagline, is it?
Yeah, right. It's pretty solid. Yeah, so yeah, man, this is the people show, man, for changing the world.
Now, if you don't know, ay-young is the USA's young leader to the UN, and he's been touring before COVID on his incredible battery tour, powered with nothing but actual renewable energy, for real. He's been walking the walk and singing the squawk. It's not a squawk, mate. You've got a beautiful voice. Basically, I'm just here to do some, like, butlering. I'm basically his Alfred. Would you like more tea, sir? I seem to...
Yeah, don't mind if I do. I got my battery tour comes. Pour the tea from across the freaking pond. He's in the UK, guys. Yo, don't mind if I do, Momo. Like, yo, each week, guys, like, real talk, each week, yo, we welcome these guests. You know, we want you outlets of the world to join us, to share, like, how, you're facing the possibilities, the new possibilities in climate change. social inequality, wherever you are in the world, like how you're addressing these issues. And I really want to know like how much you use or even know about the Global Goals, because it is the Global Goals Music Roadshow. So I want to know how much you use or know about them. And so, hey, you know, Timo, can we, shall we show the next guest?
I think we should, sir. Let's welcome this week's guest. And it is fanfare, please, if we can have one. We'll get a fanfare. We can cut it in later. It's not like it's live. Please welcome to tonight's show, it's Tara.
Oh, yeah.
Welcome, Tara. Where are you in the world?
I'm in England.
Whereabouts?
Down south. So yeah, I'm not far from Timo, but a bit away.
Cool. And do you think we should have full disclosure? I think we should have full disclosure. We might be slightly related. But that isn't why you're awesome and why we wanted to talk to you tonight. You know about the Global Goals very slightly, don't you?
A little bit.
So tell us about what you did with your gap year, because that's why we've got you in. It was remarkable. And in 12 months, you got to know the planet better than your uncle has in years of research. What did you do with your gap year?
So I made a project called 12 Months, 12 Issues, and it was basically based on the UN Global Goals. So I saw it when I was 15, didn't really think much of it. And then when I came out of school, I was a bit lost, didn't know what to do. And I saw this stuff on the news about war and poverty and hunger, and I just couldn't watch it anymore. So I thought, how can I tackle each of these in a structured way, like in a year? So I basically contacted charities, small businesses, so many different like organizations, and just went to a different country each month. So I went to like the Amazon rainforest, Greek refugee camps, Bangladesh, and like lived in these places to get to know the people and find out their stories and make it more than the news.
Wow.
That's incredible. That's incredible.
It is. It is. How many countries did you visit in that time?
That's a good question. So there was Peru for the Amazon rainforest, then 3 months in Bangladesh, then 3 months in Greece, 1 month in Cambodia. I did brief work in Vietnam and then ended up in Australia and then did some work in the UK to end off.
But you picked those countries around the Global Goals, didn't you? About, i.e. 12 months, 12 issues. That's what you call the project. And you picked those from the Global Goals. So what was it like putting all those different planet issues together in one trip?
That's cool.
Yeah, so I think at the beginning I was quite naive with it. I thought, oh, I could just do 1 month here on that issue. Like, for example, Australia, like I'll do that on life below land and life below water. And I thought it would be that easy, but actually every place had all these multitude of issues. You couldn't just go in and say, right, I'm doing this one thing, but I had almost that as my focus, that one issue. And then I learned so much more from that and how the issues connect. And it was just, yeah, really interesting.
Yeah, let's dive into that. This is crazy. We have somebody on the show. By the way, if you're tuning in, please comment. I see the comments. India, you know, she said that's amazing work. You know, this is incredible, Tara. Like, for one, to meet a change maker, someone who knows about the goals, and then you set out on a mission, you know, essentially to advance them. I mean, you took action, and that's what we say being an outlet is all about. It's taking an action. Like that. Let's talk about this a little bit more. It's interesting that you say, like, you know, you want to do like one goal at a time, or you want to do this like one thing, and then and you're starting to learn that all the issues are actually connected. Right. Like, tell me more about like understanding how, and I believe you, the issues of humanity are connected.
Yeah, for sure. Like, I think, like I said, every month. So, for example, the Amazon was, I wanted to do climate action and focusing on those issues. But I found that there's multiple things there. Like, there's people living there. There's people that have got that need sustainable cities. Like, that is an issue in itself. So each of them have these other issues underlying. And like, I did my final issue that wasn't a UN global goal on mental health, because I felt that was also the underlying of all these issues, was mental health was in all these places. And I found that really interesting, that I didn't expect. I was kind of expecting I'll just go in and do this issue. But actually, I discovered there were so many more, and mental health within that.
That's phenomenal. I mean, you know, just to ask you a question, because I mean, girl, you are impressing me. Hello, you know the goals, honey.
And hello, by the way,
if you guys are tuning in, we got some awesome people in the lineup, man. You know, I just got word that one of the homies just slid through the stage, but Tara, you know, just one question for you. I got one question.
What goal are you most plugged into? Seriously, we need to know what goal you like.
Oh, so hard to pick one. I'd say quality education, but gender equality. So gender equality in education, can I do that? Is that greedy? But yeah, those two, I'd say, are my real like passions at the moment.
Ooh, wow, so, yeah, this is crazy.
It shows the link, doesn't it, straight away, that you can't pick one without picking its implication to some of the other. So achieve gender equality and empower all women and girls. Gender bias is undermining our social fabric and devalues all of us. It's not just a human rights issue. It's a tremendous waste of the world's human potential. Yeah. And you really saw some of that before we sort of get to education and highlight that. You really saw a lot of that on your trip, especially in Bangladesh. Is that right, Tara?
Yeah, for sure. The first thing was child marriage was a major issue, and getting people to speak about that and realise that it's an issue because it's illegal there, but it still happens. And we were still talking to like government officials and things saying that we don't do it, but we found out they did. And it's so frustrating seeing it, because you meet a girl and you see her potential, but she can't go to school because she's married, and it's awful. Like, they're a child, they should have that childhood, but because they're female, they don't get it. And that just makes no sense to me, because they had so many goals and ambitions, and it was being halted because of the way it is. And it's just, yeah, I'd say child marriage really made me look at gender equality completely differently.
And you, how did they relate to you when you were going in there as a newbie, meeting these young women? How were they with you, knowing that you had very different sort of freedoms or expectations?
Well, I remember this one day, this girl said when we arrived at school and we found out she was in a marriage and she was still able to go to school. She was 14, I believe, at the time when she was married. And she said, wow, my dream's come true. And I said, oh, what's your dream? She said, oh, to meet you. And I just thought, like, wow, that is her dream, to meet me, like, as just probably a white female was what it was, and like someone from England. And that to me just like broke my heart. I was like, if that is your goal and that's where you're being told is the height of your dream, that's not good enough. Like, there is a problem in this world. Like, we need to get these girls to dream big, to believe that they can do anything. And when these prejudices are in place, that's not possible. So yeah.
Wow. See, I mean, you just said something about we need to, you know, get these people to believe, you know, but you're leading by example, and we have to have more people leading by example like you. Is, you know, someone asked a question, Caroline Peach, what was your most challenging place and why? I don't know if you answered that yet. Would love to know that again. If you're tuning in, this is the Global Goals Music Roadshow. If you have questions, we have Tara on. She's awesome. She's plugged in. She's totally an outlet that's doing change. You're making change in the world, girl. Like, I want you to know that, you know, sometimes you have to direct people on how to make change, or even help them open their eyes to see that the world is bigger or the dream could be larger, you know? So tell me, like, what built you to even make that be something that you do. Like, you're doing it. Like, what? Like, where is this coming from? Like, I'm getting confused right now. I'm like, where is this? Who is this chick, man? Where is she? What's cracking?
And I've got to interject before you answer, Tara, if you don't mind. I was just going to say, Tara started by going to the heart of the Amazon rainforest and seeing the biodiversity challenges there before then going to places like Bangladesh and taking fresh in her memory all that ecosystem stuff into poverty. I mean, that kind of contrast, Tara, what does...
This is so crazy. Like, we have so many outlets, young kids in schools right now. We're rolling this out. So shout out to all the schools listening, all our outlets.
Schools.
And I guarantee you there's so many girls listening to you right now. Like, so many people, young, they're listening to you, Tara, right now. Like, do you have something to say to them? Because, like, they're, like, listening to this young person, like you, like me, that they can relate to. Like, what would you say to them? Or, like, I mean, to me, you're bleeding action. I love that. But, like, give me some words for them, you know?
I would say, like, I don't know, like, at school, I wasn't that confident. I didn't have loads of friends. I didn't really use my voice. I was very scared to. But then when I saw these news stories and I saw things and I thought, I'm just sitting here doing nothing, there's nothing I can do. It's about changing that mindset. It's like, actually, if we all thought that, then of course nothing's going to change, but we need to actually get up and do it. And the more people that do that, like, you're going to meet so many amazing people that have that mindset as you. So it's about challenging yourself. And I think, yeah, I went in the deep end during the Amazon rainforest. Like, I used to be scared of everything. I didn't even go to, like, the shops. But I then built the confidence to go to the Amazon rainforest, do some extreme. And that really helped me mentally. It helped me, like, show that, like, give myself purpose, I think. Like, doing this charity work, it's hard, but you're doing it for other people and that gives you purpose. And, like, you're helping them use the voice that you've gained confidence to get. And that they just need the confidence to do that because everybody has that.
Yeah. Yeah. Wow.
And change is hard, right? Like, I talk about it all the time. Like, I actually was saying this. And any listeners, anybody listening, tuning in, think about change and how hard that can be. I used to talk about how when I was a kid, my parents would drag me to all these neighborhood block meetings, and they were mobilizing the community and they were pushing the government to do things. And I hated it because I had to be doing the cleanups and the night out against crime. But I look back and realize that, yeah, it was uncomfortable. I didn't like the change, right? But it built me and it builds you. And I'm seeing a change maker, a leader, you know, you got built by doing it. That's what I'm hearing.
AY, I mean, you've been out there doing it. This is what you're leading by actually taking art and music on the road and then going, look, we can actually power our rigs wherever we are in the world with battery tech and demonstrate how to do this. How did you find touring in lots of different places, even just around the US, very contrasting places? How did you find putting these different experiences together when you got out there?
Yeah, when I started doing it, you know, I started touring. Honestly, everything I'll say, it sounds similar to you. Like we have the same story. Right, like you're scared. You know, sometimes you're scared to do something, but you know you need to do it. Or you want to do it. You're led to do it, and you just take that leap of faith. You jump. Like I always talk about Steve Harvey, because he says jump. You know, sometimes you got to just jump, right? And you jump toward the change. You move toward it, and then you roll with the punches, right? You learn. You refine. It gets better, right? You know, instead of just doing my original records. You know, just my original songs, I realized, oh, shoot, that's not connecting to everybody. But when I do Garth Brooks, you know, five more people get plugged in. When I do Keith Urban, this happens here. When I did Michael Jackson, oh, shoot, now everybody's coming over. That's some universal music. And I started doing different genres and adjusting even the battery capacity, how I was charting the show, making it bigger and long. You know, you just got to start. So I think if you're paying attention, I think you just have to start. Are we on the next segment? It looks like it.
Yeah,
already.
I was going, let's I was about to say how you really earned your chops by touring as a musician, and music's really taught you how to get into different communities and speak other people's language. And your versatility as an artist means you can get away with singing, you know, Keith Urban as well as other stuff. So, yeah, it's really interesting how music's helped you do that. I reckon, let's have a look at what the Battery Tour is all about. We've got a film, haven't we?
Yeah, let's try it out.
Should we show that?
A local hip-hop artist makes an international name for himself. He is the first artist to power his concert with 100% renewable energy.
It is a real honor to recognize Mr. A.Y. Young, the founder of Battery Tour.
It's incredible. Can't wait for you to see this.
The United Nations is now throwing its support behind him.
Mr. Young has made a big impact in his young life, born in 1991. He's a singer-songwriter, a dancer, producer, entrepreneur, and sustainability advocate. He's staged and performed more than 800 concerts. He was named by the United Nations recently as one of 17 youth world leaders of the world. The only individual selected for that honor from the United States.
Stimulating this local economy further, bringing entrepreneurs together, bringing businesses together, bringing the world together. So we can make some change.
Battery Tour! I'm AY with the Battery Tour, and we're here in Honduras. It's beautiful. We're gonna bring power, solar energy, medical supplies, reading glasses, all those things to the people of Honduras. Hey, mama.
If it's true, that's what I'm amazing. Up to, but really quick, guys, really quick. It's like phone a friend. It's like, who wants to be a millionaire? We got a special guest popping in one time for the good time. My man, Deron Lloyd from the Battery Tour. Are you here, bro? Are you here? Huh?
Deron. Come in, Deron.
He's all black right now.
Yeah, he's not the best advert for the Battery Tour right now, but he'll get plugged in.
While Deron's getting plugged in, one more surprise. So I phoned. Wait, hold on. Oh shoot, it's actually ringing.
Is that my agent calling?
It's not my agent. It's one of our outlet teachers, Kathy Fogel. She's in the classroom right now, guys. Hello. Say hello.
Hi, everyone. Tara.
Hey, Cassie. Welcome.
Thank you. Tara, our students are watching right now. I'm in a closet, so my mask is off. But they have been watching you, and you are very inspirational. So thank you for all that you do. So we really appreciate it. But yes, really quick, because I have to get back. I am an outlet teacher and a very proud one. And really, it's been really powerful to hear you, Tara. And something you said earlier was you were afraid to speak up. And one thing we want to do as outlet teachers is to give our students in our classroom that opportunity to find their voice. But a lot of times people just don't know where to start, right? And so me and some other teachers, as well as Amy Hillman, have decided to start a starter kit and take AY, the Battery Tour, and his example of using his passion, right? Because that's so important, using your passion to change the world. And so we created a starter kit that we want to show every teacher around the whole globe that they can take this starter kit, right? And teach their students to have a voice and not be scared to use it. So we're super excited. We're really excited. We've been partnering with a lot of different companies and a lot of different educational platforms to get the word out. So we've been really, really busy, right, AY?
Yeah, and Cassie, I mean, Timo, you can chime in. It looks like Deron is alive and well. Deron, we're going to come to you. Deron, I know you've been paying attention and listening. Guys, Deron's from the Battery Tour. Cassie Fogel's one of our outlet teachers. This is one of the coolest guests we've ever had, which is Tara. Right here, like, what do you guys think about her story? Like, is that inspiring you? How does that make you feel? Like, we're all kind of coming together to change the world, right? To turn the world to this battery to power change. Like, how does Tara's story make you feel about yours? Tell us a little bit about your story, just in general. Like, just kind of like let's expand, Timo. What's up? Neron, Cassie, which one?
Yeah, I can go first because I got to hop off here in a second. But like I said, Tara, I think your story just motivates me and empowers what the work that we're doing and make more of people like you, but make them not be afraid to use their voice and find a place to start. That's the world is such a big and scary place. Right. And that they don't think they can tackle these world problems, but they can. And so my job is to try to teach teachers and parents and whoever else wants a place to start that they can. And I know it's a different way of changing the world, but I do feel like if I can make more people like Tara out there, then I'm doing my job. And so thank you so much. And you're very inspirational and keep doing what you're doing. And just know that you have a school full of students listening to you right now. And so that's pretty amazing. So thank you guys. I'm sorry I have to run.
Say bye to our
Thanks for dropping in. Take care. Duran, welcome, man. Glad we could get you plugged in. Welcome to the show. So how are you connected to the battery tour? How do you know my colleague AY?
Well, AY is a long-term friend of me. Well, first, Tara, I love your work that you're doing, and it's definitely an inspiration to the world. And actually, our team, we live and preach that that methodology and that ideology. So just to know that it's other people out there that's thinking like us is just a beautiful thing. Mm. So, AY, I met AY when we were maybe 14, 15, both in high school. He was homeschooled.
You have some stories. You have stories, my friend. I want to hear them. We'll chat in another thread.
Yeah. So, we have a long time story. So we've been through a lot of things, and I've seen him go through bullying, and I was the one who stopped the bullying. So, you know, we've been friends ever since. You know, I didn't have money, and I was the one that helped support the battery tour. You know, my wife was like, hey, what are you putting? Why are you buying 45 shirts and we got a light bill to pay? I believe in the battery tour. You know, he's going to get the world plugged in one day. So now we're at this point here where we're actually plugging in the world, and we're living and speaking and dreaming what we've been doing forever, basically. So now the world is actually getting to see it.
Duran, I'm really feeling that, man. And I think it's interesting you mentioned bullying there and mental health. Tara was saying earlier how, you know, coming back from the world, you said to me the other day, actually, Tara, that everywhere you go, we're just people. You realize everyone's dealing with the same mental health issues, no matter what the culture, and things like bullying are part of that. Expectations not fitting. Tara, expand a bit on that if you would, kind of what you've found, especially lately, being back and lockdown and dealing with stuff.
Yeah, so I found like every country I went to, mental health was so visible. So whether it was in Bangladesh, people couldn't love and marry who they wanted, or you couldn't get water in Cambodia, or you're in a refugee camp and you don't feel safe. So there's big issues with self-harm and like really bad mental health issues that were just everywhere. And I think now with COVID, we almost have like a similar ground of like something we all don't have, or like we just have a lot more similarities. And so it's much easier to talk about mental health because there's usually more of a common ground. But yeah, I naively thought it was a very like, oh, social media is the influence, but actually that's a big issue here. But around the world, mental health is just so prevalent. I really want people to understand that.
Yeah. This taps into when you were talking about education. This is the education goal. Ensure inclusive and equitable quality education and promote lifelong learning and opportunities for all. They call it goal number four, quality education. Definitely education. But when I researched it for my research cast, I found stuff. It really taught me how this stuff all fits together. I have the reason I got into the global goals as a daft music maker is it was actually a music project that led me to discover the global goals. And that's kind of another story. But when I found them, I realized I had to try and make sense of them as a complete outsider, as a creative. So I created Unsee the Future. And it was my way of looking at the goals from totally outside, without trying to learn the mantra and which one's which, what are the numbers, what color goes with a quote it. I just thought, as an outsider, does this model make sense? And it transformed my view of the world, actually, because it showed me that all these different goals are just different symptoms of the same thing. And it's our shared culture. It's an economic culture. And everything of them is just like falling out of human behavior as a result of what we value and how. But in education, I've got just one quote from the post of Unsee the Future. It was episode 14. I did two episodes on education. There's a brilliant TED talk by Sir Ken Robinson, who's now sadly died. It's very famous for those who know education stuff, and it was inspiring. His opening quote is, "It's my contention that all children have tremendous talents, and we squander them pretty ruthlessly." It's the idea that we don't, he goes on to expand inspiringly, and it's really stayed with me. I'd be interested to know what Cassie thinks, that we don't teach kids right. We teach them, he says, like they're just heads in jars, not whole humans. He said, why don't we teach children to dance and drama right the way up to the age of 18? Because everybody has emotions to make sense of, everybody has bodies to grow comfortable with, and yet we sort of almost don't teach that at all. And this, to me, just made me think this is a big part of how we're all so disconnected. So that's my little Unsee the Future kind of.
Yeah. I mean, I just to harp on that, it's like we end up teaching ourselves. It goes back to what you were saying, Tara, earlier, is you took action. Again, I go back to action. That's what we're about. What we're being an outlet is about is taking action. Duran, like, speak on this, bro, because I know you, bro, right? It's like, you know, you didn't get handed anything. I mean, talk about like how you taught yourself. I mean, you know, how did you even come to do what you do? You know, tell a little bit more about that.
Bit about me. I own a construction company named Freeman, and we basically do full turnkey remodels. Now we're going into doing full turnkey net zero homes. So I had a rough background. I dropped out of college. By default, I had a 4.0 GPA, and I did not know that basically it was going to happen. So I applied to 50 other grants, and basically was denied. So I went homeless for about 9 months. And when you talk about mental health, thinking about jumping off a bridge every single day, you can think of anything, you know. I was going through that. So and then I basically went into construction, working $10 an hour. So I humbled myself and learned to trade. But I also told myself when I went to work construction, went back home and lived with my mom that I wasn't going to be there for long. So I took the strides and I learned how to operate the business that I was in better. So I basically took control over his books and basically seen that he was only basically making $5,000 a month. I mean, $5,000 each week in profit. So I basically, within 6 months, I turned that $5,000 each week into $15,000. So I basically automated his system. So after that, I asked him within a raise, you know, I said, hey, I'm making $10 an hour. Can I at least get some kind of raise? You know, I'm running all your books. You're going out of town. You know, can I get something? Well, he offered me a dollar raise. It was okay. I said, all right, you know. Ultimately, I went and worked for another company. And guess what? I had to do the same thing over. So I did the same thing over with a whole nother construction field. And then I went, that was another smaller company. So then I went to a bigger company, which was Lithco Construction. And they were a commercial, they still are probably number three top country construction company in the world. But I went to them and I basically started automating their systems also. So I went in there as a laborer. you know, worst of the worst case scenario, in this field in Kansas City, there's no black people in construction. So you're let alone you're against adversity. You know, you're against a lot of things that you don't think about as a young guy. And my father passed away. He passed away 5 years ago. So my guidance only went as far as I knew. You know, so I'm literally learning on the job. So I basically went to building their system as a laborer. He seen how hard I worked. I was a basketball player. I had D1 scholarships also. So I was athletic, and I could do a lot more than the next person in the construction field. So the guy came up to me and said, "Hey, you need more money." So I'm like, "Whoa," you know. I was confused. So then he offered me a $3 raise. I was making $18 an hour at that point. So I was like, "Oh, okay." So I contacted this guy. His name Juan Barone. Shout out to Juan. Good guy. He basically had graduated from K-State University, and he was very good at his job. I seen that he was stressed. You know, he's going through different things. I said, "Hey, man, how can I take the load off of you?" So I basically did the same thing. You know, anything you can help the next person do, you got to realize you're going to be in that position in 5 years if you plan on being a boss. So you have to, you know, do this little steps like that to keep growing yourself in business. And it goes as long as basically treating people right. You know, if you treat that next person right, only the good things is going to come out of it. So that's the mentality.
That's powerful.
Yeah, that's the mentality I always had growing into construction. So I basically learned fully how to lay out a building. I took all the blueprints from Juan. Every single time I got home, I worked on the areas that I was not good at in my work field. So a lot of people would like go home and then they're tired and they go to sleep. No, when I went home, I worked on the areas that I was not good at. If I did not understand it, I made sure that I understood it the next day. So then after that, I learned out fully how to lay out a building. So I not only learned how to first read and interpret prints for people, then I learned how to fully lay out a building. So that's two different fields. Laying out a building, you have to use a $35,000 machine and actually fully lay it out. So
I was just going to say, you know, what led you then to be doing, I mean, you've learned everything layer by layer. Yep. Really grafted, mate. But so you know the value of stuff because you've done it from the ground up, right? But what led you to build sustainable building? That's what you do now, is that right?
Well, eventually I wanted to, that's what I'm getting at. Every trade that I went to, I had to basically learn that to learn what I wanted to do, which is what? Full net zero homes. So I had to learn each individual trade. You know, you can't lead a horse to water without knowing how to drink it. You know, it just doesn't make sense. So you got to figure out how to actually do it yourself, and then at least know how to do it. You know, that way, if you go tell the guy that's brooming the stairs, "Hey, go broom the stairs," you know that it takes actually 45 minutes. You can't tell him it takes 15 minutes and you've never broomed the stairs.
Yeah, see, and that goes back, right? That connects to what Tara was saying earlier. And I think that why this is a special episode, Tara. I'm so happy to have you and Duran, because, you know, you're going back to taking an action and doing it. Doing the small things got you where you're at. Tara, what you were talking about, you set out to, and you went and did it, right? And you learned more, and you reiterate. Like, Tara, do you have any thoughts on that again? Just expand a little bit more on that for a quick second.
Yeah, I was actually thinking, like, when you're speaking, is like the development sector and charity work, it's constant failures, or things going wrong, or you having to work for what you want to get done. And like exactly like what you're saying, like you're having to fight for where you want to get to. And I think that is development and these goals in general, is you're gonna have pushbacks throughout. You're gonna have these high level people saying you can't do that or we can't do that. and it's frustrating, but you have to keep on going, because if we all have that attitude of give up now, you're not going to achieve that.
And everybody high five me one time, high five.
It is that time. Now we're on an inspirational high where you guys are all, everybody here is fighting and learning how to look after themselves. We need some uplift. Anyway, you've got some music to share with us. Is that right, man?
And now I'm performing live, even though I'm not live because I'm not performing right now, but it's live at the same time, but performing.
Hey, I just want a man, and she ain't got no man. They do some mama scenes, baby, put me in a dress, okay, okay. Hit the floor like underlay. Me cop the suit if you wanna stay. All you think no to take a place. You Cali into like a summer day. Make your mind cause you my babe. Mommy just high like a fever, dressed like a diva. Then I don't change. Spinning this hair rolls, hey. And she ball up the whole day, yeah. Come on, style, supposed at the drop. When I see you pop, this is a lot. We chart top, I can envy not. Cause they drop. Oh yeah.
The boy's still good, and he still got it.
To my seat really fast, bro. Like that was
well done. You are fast, and
my roll. Switch up the shirt, threw on the hat, and now it's time to get the world plugged in. What's up, man? Where are we? We got to make sure people are signing up, right? We got to make sure people are getting plugged in. We're getting toward the end of this thing, guys. Register. Tara, if you're not plugged into the battery tour, you already are an outlet, a change maker. But guys, if you're listening, register to be a part of the battery tour. Join us on this Global Goals project that we're doing. I didn't talk too much about it, but we're doing this really awesome thing, right? We're working with the biggest artists in the world, you know, to achieve the goals of the world in three phases. We are in phase one. We're doing a sustainable album, a sustainable tour next year. You can be a part of that too, and part of the guidebook. Tara, be a part of this change. That's what we want people to do, to sign up and to take the outlet of the outlets that take action, empower the tour.
Yeah, exactly. We ask everybody to do the same two things, whether you are Shell or Shelby, we ask the same two things, power the tour and do one thing to change where you are. And that, and if you can do it by plugging your passion into it, you'll find it's a lot easier to do. That's what we're trying to do. Help people plug their passion into.
Exactly. Right. I mean, I'll give an example because, you know, things are moving and it's getting on time. But like, you know, as individuals can power the tour, obviously by your voice. You can share this on Facebook, Instagram. You want to say you're an outlet, say you're plugged in. You can donate $1. You can buy a shirt. That's how you're powering this change that we're doing to happen. But you can also take an action, right? And an action could be getting involved at the local soup kitchen. It could be doing what you did, Tara, right? Taking trips to different places around the world and helping people, taking action. It could be recycling. You know, that is so powerful. Like, you know, Tara, I am so impressed by you today. I'm so honored that you were on this show. Like, I mean, girl, you're amazing. You're freaking amazing. And Deron, you're my dude. Like, yeah, shoot, I'm getting all kinds of calls. And AJ's here. What's cracking, AJ? I gotta get in the studio. Yo, Timo, okay. Man, I'm gonna have to roll up out of here.
Before
like,
we go,
like literally
we,
right now.
Yeah, if I and there he is gone. I mean, that's the life of AY Young. When you got to bounce, you got to bounce. That, you know, that dude has a lot going on right now, and he's trying to literally power the world. So, hey, look, both of you, thank you so much for joining us tonight. Duran, I found you inspiring, man. I'm really feeling it, everything that you shared tonight and how it tied in with other stuff. Bless you for supporting AY so much and for getting behind this. I'm so impressed with how you've grafted. I think there's a shared testimony here tonight about having to graft and face your fears and learn and fight and not give up and then somehow manage your well-being step by step and be kind to yourself. So bless you both. Tara, it's always fantastic talking to you. Thank you for joining us tonight and sharing some of 12 Month 12 Stories. Guys, do you have any last thing left to say? Duran, is any last thing you want to leave us with before we go?
Just be an outlet for change. Support the next individual around you. That's all I can tell you. Mm. Pleasure to be on here with you, Tim. Same thing, Tara. And God bless you, Terry. Keep doing what you're doing. Only good is going to come out of it. So.
And Tara, what would you like to leave us with?
Yeah, I'd just say, like, if you don't have the confidence in yourself, just try. And the mentality that I take is think of other people, and that helps me have the confidence. If I'm doing my actions for somebody else, it gives me the confidence to do it rather than for myself. And yeah, that helps me a lot. And if that helps someone else make a change, then that mentality, I think, really is helpful.
Yeah. None of us are superstars. I mean, AY kind of is. So, but in a sense, most of us are just ordinary folk. He's an ordinary person too, actually. He's just brilliantly talented. And all of us are trying to fight and make our way and feel that we can engage with the world. Well, the point of the Global Goals Music Show is, yes, you can. You can engage. You belong to the world the same as the rest of us. If you're watching this, it's your planet. Now, I don't mean it's your problem. It's everybody's problem, but it's your world and you belong to it. So you have a right to speak up and try and shape it, because you can, because you're a human. Look, lots of love to both of you tonight. Thank you so much for carving out time to join us on the show. This will be online. Safe journeys home, wherever you're both going now. Tara, thank you very much. And Duran, goodbye to both of you. Have a lovely rest of your Thursday. Bye.
Bye.
And yeah, so that's our show for this week, episode 5. And what have we learned today? Well, we thought about education, we thought about equality. And how are these things linked, and how it's quite hard doing a cheesy feel-good thing when these are quite serious issues. But we've got a bit of a clash here in styles. Yeah, they shouldn't leave me here at the end, because I just start mucking about. But it has been a lovely show. And, you know, even as a daft Brit, I felt that tonight, and I love getting a top-up of feel-good from everybody. Tara's just an ordinary person. She went out and saw the world and brought it home, and it can be tough to then share that experience with other people at home who aren't quite where you are. She was saying to me the other day, I wish I could sort of just share it and wake other people up to the same thing. And I'll leave you with a quote from Tara, actually, that I put into Unsee the Future some time ago. She said, before I went away, the global goals were just this sort of academic thing. Then traveling the world and meeting all these people. These goals are no longer some chart on a wall anymore. They're friends with names and faces and stories. That's what the global goals are. They're people. And I was about to make myself tear up at the end, and then I did a really cheesy chord and made myself laugh instead. Thank you for watching the Global Goals Music Roadshow with AY Young and some bloke in a shed called Timo Peach. Find us online, sign up for the battery tour at ayyoung.com. If you've got questions about how the global goals even work, whether they can help you, if you've got a testimony about how you're being an outlet for change, join us, please do. That's our show.